Welcome or welcome back. Thanks for watching. I will say I've started off very bad and the camera will flip. I had it facing the left, and to record I normally face it right because it captures more to the right than the left depending on how I set up, and I did not realize I set it up backwards, so I do apologize for that. You won't see great application on my thumb to start off with. I tried to leave it in, but also fast forward it so you wouldn't have to sit through, you know, all the bad angles and whatnot. So I do apologize. And here is the camera flip. There we go. Hopefully we stay in frame now. I'm sorry, you guys. I'm getting bad with staying in frame. I don't know what's wrong with me lately. Anyways, this has nothing to do with my issues with filming and the camera and everything. No, this has to do with our Valentine's Day collection. I have asked a few lovely ladies that I admire their work. I couldn't reach out to everyone that I wanted to, but that's okay. There's always more opportunities, and I hope, you know, this doesn't discourage anyone from reaching out to me or letting me know or inviting me to their collaborations. I'm open to work with anyone and everyone. I love my nail community and I appreciate you all. So if anyone wants in the future to do anything, just let me know. But so the collaboration for Valentine's Day is Bella Boo Nails, Tabitha, Juan's Wife Toy, Sick Tips, myself, Alicia's Glam Nails, Latina Nail Designs, and Juicy Fruit Nails. So, I believe that's everyone in the collaboration. I so wanted Cynthia to join, but maybe on the next one. Love you, girl. I love all you ladies, and I appreciate you all for joining my collaboration. I tried to put together, this is my first one, so if it wasn't like super great, I do apologize. I hope to earn more experience putting a collaboration together and giving information and passing all that along. So I really hope I tagged everyone, and I will, if you're not tagged in the short, I will tag you in the description box for the short. This is also a collaboration with Madam Glam. We are all using Madam Glam's cruelty-free wonderful products that, you know, everyone knows that they're hemi-free, cruelty-free. They're just great products. I don't want to go down the list because I'm sure you'll hear that a lot. And I just want you to know how fabulous it is. Like, I really, really do like the pigmentation. And the set came out. I've been wanting to do this set for ever since I got the colors, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I have the perfect idea. I really want to do this. And I fought it. I had done a live. I'd done three lives, actually. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. I was a guest on Donna. Oh, my dear Donna. Dawn. Like the dawn of the day. Yes, you know? Okay. Well, I wanted to do the set probably, I want to say it was Friday or Saturday. It was just, I was itching for it. And then I finally got to sit down Sunday after the live. And I'm like, I'm going to knock this out. I have to knock this out. The date is coming up really soon. And I did not want to be late to my first gathering of the collaboration. So I hope I showed up and I done justice to the set. Like, I hope it's legible. I hope you guys like it. It's something I really looked forward to. My end nail art, when it gets there, I'll talk about it. But I do apologize. So if you have any questions of anything I'm using, it should be linked in the description box. But if it's not, you can just drop a comment. I will be sure to answer you on that. And again, thank you, Toy, Juicy, aka Robin, Latina, Alicia, Sick Tips, Tabitha, and Bella Boone. Thank you guys for joining me on this collaboration. I so look forward to your guys' work. Everyone, make sure you go check out all these lovely ladies and their creativity for Valentine's Day set. Maybe you'll get some inspiration or, you know, kind suggestions on what could be improved. If anything, I know mine needs improvement. I doubt theirs will, but just keep it friendly. And thanks for watching. I will talk to you in a bit.
Club in my taxi cab, everybody's looking at me now. Like, who's that chick that's rocking kicks? She gotta be from out of town. So hard with my girls not around me. It's definitely not a Nashville party, 'cause all I see is stilettos. I guess I never got the memo. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kind of homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. It's when the DJ drops my favorite tune.
Si han llegado a este punto, a lo mejor ya saben que estamos haciendo un colaboración a donde vamos a estar múltiples mujeres haciendo diferente tipo de uñas para el día de San Valentín. Me gustaría si pueden ir a visitar sus canales, a ver su trabajo. Y todos vamos a estar trabajando con la pinta uñas de Madame Glam. So, ahí nos dejas saber cómo te gustan los diseños y todo lo que salga de nuestra colaboración. Gracias por ver el canal y te hablo más al rato para explicarte cómo va el proceso. Okay, so you see that the nail popped off as I was filing it? I didn't do nail prep, and I didn't even lay down base coat, okay? So I didn't expect it to pop off that quickly. I was so friggin' disappointed. But I did not realize that I had a friggin' huge advantage at this point. And so after, I glue the darn things back on. I glue them back on when I could have took full advantage and done the designing. You see how easily they just came off? That's because there's no prep to the natural nail. There's no filing, buffing, dehydrating, priming. There's nothing done to my natural nail. I glued the tips on, and that was that. I expected them to last at least a day, not to pop off while I'm filing. So I was a little irritated with myself, but that is, I know I have myself to blame, so I can't be mad at that. Which also gave me a benefit that I can work on the next set on my hand, and that's fine. I'm fine with that. But what I did not realize at this moment in time, that with these nails popped off, I could have took full advantage and put them on a freaking stand, like, you know, one of the press-on stands. I could have put them on and done the design on there, and it would have been so much easier, and I feel like I would have loved how they came out. I do like how they came out, but I didn't love how they came out, if you get my drift. Like, and here I was just perfecting the back end, because for whatever reason on my finger it wouldn't go back on, which is why I glued them back on so rapidly, finished filing them and glued them right back on, because they are acrylic and I didn't want them to shrink. And as you know, if you do pop off, then they shrink. So I'm a little annoyed with myself, but I'm going in with my base coat from Madame Glam, and we are going to start to design these nails. I will be using the nail stickers, water decals, I mean, over here to the right of the screen. And yes, they are Marilyn Monroe. I wish she had Selena. Like, oh, so wish she had Selena. But I love Marilyn Monroe, and the hoodie I'm wearing in this is Marilyn Monroe with a bandana. I'll have to take a picture and like put it on the screen somewhere. I don't know if I don't think I've learned how to do that yet, but yeah. I'm going in with the perfect white. That is going to be my background for Marilyn, and I am going to go in and do. I had a different thought how I wanted to do these, and I thought I was gonna put white on nail. I don't know how I envisioned it, but when I went to do it, it just wasn't working for me. So I stuck with the white, perfect white. This is Madame Glam's perfect white, and I tell you, it is absolutely the perfect white. I put it on. What I didn't show you is I put another layer of base coat, so it will have like an extra tacky layer to grip onto the water decal when I pull it out. That's why you'll see as soon as I lay it down, it sticks. Like, if you're trying to put like stickers or water decals over these, they do have a tacky layer that helps anything adhere. I love that, absolutely love that. And here I'm just meshing out the air bubble that was in the side of the sticker. Okay, so there's that now. I'm going to get the red. This red is called the red, okay? That is actually the name. The word the, or however you pronounce it, the, T-H-E, red. That is the color, the name of this color. It is perfect red, like, I don't do makeup, but if I did, this would be, I guess, a perfect red lip, like a sexy red color. Yes, that's this color. I'm sorry my hair and my head got in the camera. I blocked you guys. I'm drawing out a Frenchie, and ay, me perdonan, me disculpan que mi cabeza, estoy bien cabezona, obviamente se me ve el pelo, te estoy bloqueando, no puedes ver que estoy dibujando un Frenchie en la uña. Y estoy contemplando qué voy a hacer. Pues voy a hacer un Frenchie blanco en la otra uña. El color que usé para el rojo se llama la roja. El rojo. El blanco es el blanco perfecto, así se llama en la página, blanco perfecto. Okay, so I'm going in and doing a second Frenchie. I'm measuring out, like, to compare where, if they add up or line up, whatever. And I tried going about it a different way. So, I don't know, I just do them different ways, okay? Don't judge. There's no judging here. I don't judge, so. I don't know. I just went about it differently. I don't know why. I don't know why I did that, but I did. So. And then I'm just straightening out the, or rounding out the straightened edge and filling in whatever needs to be filled in. And then I will use my finger to clear out whatever the little eye applicator thing didn't clear out. Like there's a one little droplet of white in the center on the nude that I didn't want there. And you'll see me tap it off and then cure. So, yeah, you see? Tap, clean it up. Okay, we're good. We're going to cure. And then we're going in with the red again. And look how pigmented these colors are. One coat. I did not have to use a second coat. It is the perfect opaqueness. Like these, I could imagine for like the red bottom nails. I think this would be perfect. I actually do want to try that. So that's what we're doing. And we're doing another Frenchie. This one is off-centered and it. I think this one bothered me a little bit. I didn't perfect it. Like one side is thicker, and then I want to go in. Oh, I haven't got to the thumb yet. I am drawing the lips, you guys, and this is why I said I should have kept the nails popped off. I could have drawn the lips perfectly with my right hand. I can draw lips, but I drew with my left hand, so I got no excuses. But I will let you finish watching the design, and if anything, I will come back. Oh, before we get there, I will tell you. Oh no, we got time. I'll tell you when we get there. so I believe we're to the point I've changed my mind. I put on the base coat and I tried to marble it, and it did marble just fine. Like, I feel like it would have been better had I put more product and it would have, like, mixed better, you know? But it wasn't working for me. I didn't love it. So, yes, I have to fill in the little gaps because I did put thick amounts of white and thick amounts of red. So, I left little, you know, gaps that I had to fill in with the red polish, which is fine, you know? Like I said, these came off almost immediately. Well, you've seen them already pop off, so you know they're going to be easy when it's just glue with no prep. It's the consequence of, like, not doing no prep, but it is what it is. It's okay. Like I said, the benefit to that is that I get to do something else sooner. So I'm putting, like, a little bit of my McCart gel. Yes, I found it. I'm ecstatic about it. It is almost gone. I do need to order another one. And I'm going in with this little, like, cuticle liner. It's a gold liner. Then I'm going to go in with these stickers and just put them all over the hearts to tie the gold that I put above Marilyn Monroe on my nails. And you see me draw the XO and the kisses. And you see how well that white just pops, and with one layer, like, you can do it thin or thick, it doesn't matter, it still shows up. And so the red does too. Like, you see the kisses, like, they're not transparent, they're pretty obvious, you know, they pop. So I feel like they would have popped a lot better had I drew them with my dominant hand, but I didn't, so I can't keep complaining about it. It's fine. I'm going in with the hearts, and I'm just filling in, like, the little blank spaces. I wanted to tie in the gold thing I put on top of Marilyn. I don't know what that's called. It's like a cuticle bar bead. It's not a bead. It's like a bar, but anyways. Oh, one of my daughters helped me put the heart on, and look, what a coincidence. Broken heart. We do surgery and put it back together, so it's fine. And then, yeah, we're just going to finish up these nails, and then I will be top coating with the wonderful Madame Glam, which will leave them all shiny and beautiful, and also put it over top of the charms as to when I wash my hands, they will not corrode. I did keep this on for 2 days. They did stay on for 2 days after gluing them back on the initial time when you've seen them pop off. Oh, there's my other daughter being helpful. And how sweet. Oh, my babies. Anyways, we are going to do a blooming rose on the thumb. I didn't know how it would look or how satisfied I would be. I put a really generous amount of base coat on my nail to get this, okay? Really, really generous amount of base coat. So it will, like, spread. And then you see me going around doing, like, petals. So drop a comment if you have a better way to do it. I'm going to look in and see if Madame Glam has blooming gel. They probably do. I just didn't see it. So if they do, I'm going to reach out and be like, hey, let me order some blooming gel. But yes, this is my Madame Glam Valentine's Day set with the colors Perfect White and the Red. And I cannot wait to see what colors everyone else uses and what their creations are. I'm sure it's all going to be very beautiful. And I cannot wait. Thank you again, everyone, for joining. And I look forward to seeing your work. You guys take care, stay blessed, and I will see you all on the next one.
las promesas de amor, mira mía, que nos hicimos frente al altar.
Yo no les doy el gusto y eso les pica.
Yo soy bien picosa, on fire. Hey. Yo nunca me dejo de nadie.
No.
A mí su pique no me hace nada.
No.
Porque soy la salsa más brava. No le busquen que yo soy
bien salsa.
Si me cucan me sacan.
Lo chilosa.
Yo sé que ustedes me miran.
Yo soy bien picosa, on fire.
Hey.
Yo nunca me dejo de nadie.
No.
A mí su pique no me hace nada.
No.
Porque soy la salsa más brava.
No le busquen que yo soy
bien salsa.
Si me cucan, me sacan.
Lo chilosa.
Yo sé que ustedes me miran.
Sabrosa.
Pero cuidado que yo estoy
picosa.
No le busquen que yo soy
bien salsa.
Si me cucan, me sacan.
Lo chilosa.
Yo sé que ustedes me miran.
Sabrosa.
Pero cuidado que yo estoy
picosa.
No le busquen que